How many of you here got budget planning? Okay, so you are making mistake number one. Okay? So this Harry, he talks to himself, you know, I barely get any money that I'm making, right? Why do I need to create a detailed budget? True, you're getting from PTPTN, not enough also, you know, what for do budget? Is it this case? What's the reason that you're not doing budget? Because you don't know what to do. Because parents never do, so we learn from parents. Is it? Okay, so, you know, he'll just tell himself, you know, I'll be lucky if I can just pay all my bills. You know, I barely can pay for bills, so if I can settle all, okay, I'll do enough. Consider my budget is good, don't need to plan. Okay? So the second thing is that, okay, anyone know what's the root of all evil? Anyone? Root of all evil? Credit card. Okay, credit card. And again, you know, after getting your car loan, bank, very smart, super smart, they will offer you credit card. You know, if you are afford to take car loan, they definitely offer you credit card. So they will ask you, hey, your salary annually how much? So come pick up, we offer you this credit card. Okay, so again, for Harry Pace, he talks to himself, you know, I'm going to make good use of it. You know, a lot of people say, credit card is good, get point, you know, go pump petrol, get point, grocery, get points. How many of you got credit card here? Your parents suck for you. Parents suck for you. Very, very lucky. Okay, so points, right? You can use your points to, you know, go and get some rebate or even get some free gift. Not to redeem, but redeem gift, okay? But the thing is that really the case? Most of it, no. That's why you see bank likes to promote credit card. Because there's a good business there. Because most of the people, they won't pay in full, okay? And that's the mistake number two, abuse of credit card. Did y'all know that a lot of people, especially age below 30 in Malaysia, the bankruptcy rate, all because of credit card, as well as car loan. Okay? So, how do these abuse of credit cards come along? Anyone know this? Okay, come, tell me, what is this? iPhone, what model? I also don't know. Okay, I have Apple iPhone, okay? What about this? iPad. What version? Okay, lah, iPad lah. What about this? This one sure no lah. Anyone ever drink before? Starbucks? Anyone? All drink before? All very rich. Okay, good. Okay, in Penang, you see, I believe now Kampa a lot of cafe as well, right? Yesterday, last night, we went around quite a lot of cafe. How's their price? How's their price? Expensive? Not expensive. Okay, affordable. Okay, compared to normal stock? You all don't go cafe, or stay at home. Mama, okay, very good. Save a little bit also. Mama actually also not cheap, right? If you take chicken, take veggie, easily also 7 ringgit, 8 ringgit, right? Okay, so you see in Penang, there's a lot of cafe. If you've been to that, I'm sure you know. And you know, one meal easily costs up to 20 ringgit, 30 ringgit. So that's another expenses, right? Watch, shoes. You don't know what brand is this? This one. Yes, Nike, okay? So all of these, temptation, right? Temptation. As if they are asking you, come, buy me. Okay? So more expenses, right? On top of those that I've mentioned before. So for Harry, he doesn't know that, you know, for proper financial planning, our recommendation is that there should be, if you look at this, For your essential expenses, it should be 50% of your take-home pay. And then 20% should go to your future saving, and 30% goes to your lifestyle choice. So, does Harry do that? Does Harry do that? No, right? So as you can see from here, Harry's actual spending, he actually left 11% for future savings only. Is that enough? Is that enough? So he actually puts his future in jeopardy, alright? So the next thing is that, the next mistake is that since he's only putting 11%, right? So he won't have enough emergency fund. Okay? Since you all are all students, I mean, this is the thing that you should know, right? After you come out to work, you should have emergency fund, right? Anyone know what's the purpose of emergency fund? Finance students? Just now, who's a finance student? Now suddenly, all quiet already. Okay, never mind. Emergency fund. Okay, can you promise you yourself, or can someone or a company promise you that you can work in their company for the rest of your life? Is there any company? Utah will promise you? Mr. Payu? No, it's alright. So yes, we never know, right? One day we might lose our job. Okay, what about accident? Right, there's a lot of unexpected things that would happen. So this is where the emergency fund would come in handy. But again, so for Harry, he will be completely vulnerable, right? And the next mistake, mistake number four, no retirement fund. Okay? He's not going to put into PRS. Anyone know PRS? No? Okay, don't know. Never mind. Little Q&A, ask me. Okay? So he just started to work. You know, Harry, he asked himself, I just started to work. Why so fast think about retirement? Imagine he's just 23. Okay, I ask you all. You all are around 20, right? Have you all think about retirement? Haven't start to work before think about retirement, right? Okay, acceptable. But I have to say for Harry case, at age 23, when he started to work, do you all think that he should start to think about his retirement?
Yes.
So make sure you all do also, huh? Okay. So for him, you know, 23, let's say work until 55. So there's another 22 years of working life only until retirement, right? So still long to go. So probably you say, you know, it's okay later. So let's fast forward to 20 years later, okay? 20 years later, how old is he? 20 years later. Come, Max, simple Max.
43.
Hello?
43.
Okay, thank you, 43. So at age 43, Harry probably changed car a few times already, right? So car loan's still there. PTPN loan? Do you think that PTPN loan's still there?
Yes.
No more. Why? The lady in this yellow shirt? Okay, come. Everyone give her. That's the ideal case. But in actual, do you all have any friends, you know, probably around 30 plus? So are they still really paying their PTPN? Or have they started to pay? Okay, you all go back, ask your friends, those 30 plus one. High chances, not yet. Okay? I can see that, I mean, it's not a good thing to tell you, but PTPTN is the best. We can't even call him a loan shark. Loan shark is not good, right? He's like the best loan. Because never chase you, right? Maybe, okay, once in a long while, send you some letters. And the worst also, okay lah, blacklist, so don't let you go out, go overseas. So you pay a bit, okay, you can go out, okay. Right? It's not that, you know, he's going to sue you or anything. But of course, you all still have to pay lah. I'm not encouraging you not to pay. Okay, credit card debt, for sure, right? There's now so many temptations. Marriage loan? Anyone of you already married here? No, still young. Okay, actually quite a lot of girls here. Okay, for guys, how do you think? How much do you need for marriage? Okay,
30,000.
Sorry?
30,000.
Enough?
For
buffet, maybe. Yes, yes. And also depends on location, right? If you do it in hotel, and it depends on the number of tables, right? Yes, so again, high chances marriage loan is over there. Okay, the next thing, personal loan. Possible? Possible, right? Housing loan? For sure. Anyone thinks that, you know, one day you can buy a house without a housing loan? You can pay cash, 500k, 1 million. Cash. Alright. So housing loan. Definitely. Okay? So all these things after 20 years. Okay. Max time. That's your max again. How many years to go until retirement? Now he is 43. How many years to go? How many years? 12. Okay? So whenever he's overspent, then he will go to credit card. Okay, as usual. So at age 43, with 12 years to go, then only start to think about retirement. Enough time. So if you are Harry's friend, what would you recommend him? What would you tell him? You should think about it earlier lah. But now too late lah. Okay, so with 12 years to go, you know, with one wife and two kids, and with 6.5 average EBF dividend, you all know what's the rate EBF dividend last year? Finance student, can I have a show of that? Cannot answer the question already. Okay, so do you all know what's the EBF dividend rate for last year? Or finance student don't have to know actually. Okay, so it's actually 6.75. But throughout the years, we will get an average around 6.5. Okay? So with 6.5 average EPF dividend, the estimated total EPF saving will be around 500k without withdrawal. You know, provided that there's no withdrawal. Enough? Again, I'll ask. Enough? How long do you think that Harry would live until? 60? 70. How, okay, maybe I ask, how old you all think that you all will live until?
100?
Okay, maybe 1,000. 70? Raise your hand. 70? No. 80? 90? 100? Those that in this one is what? More than 100. It's good that you live more than 100. But financially, can you afford?
No.
Can you afford to live that long? Do you know how much you need to live that long? Right, unless you work forever. Right? So 500k for 30 years. Assuming, you know, he's going to live until 55 plus 30, 85. Okay? 85 standard, right? Enough, 500k for 30 years. No, right? So is this serious? Is he in a serious situation?
Yes.
So will you all be like him? So you all know what to do already, right?
Yes.
Okay. So let's pause for a second. Okay? I want you all to pause for a second. Look at Harry case. You know he's an engineer. 3k for a fresh grad, quite high, right? Not quite high lah, consider high lah. What about those other jobs, you know, that gets lower than that income? I think quite common, right, with those lower than 3,000, right? Okay, so let's look at the national impact. Okay, today if Paris is like this, what about, you know, there's 100 of Paris, you know, there could be 1,000 of Paris. Possible? Possible? 30 million Malaysian citizens, right? Possible or not? So do you all see where we are heading to without a proper financial literacy? Okay? Big house. Who want big house? Who doesn't want big house? You don't want big house. Then you want what you want? Medium house, okay? Early retirement. Anyone want? Okay, come, raise your hand. Show your commitment. I want early retirement. The rest? The one? You want live, you want work forever? Okay, no choice, you want work forever? So, is it still possible? Still possible? For Harry? Okay, let's say for Harry, possible. For you all? Good, okay, I like it. Yes, you all have to be confident. So you all know what you should do? Or you all know what you should not do? Okay, so you all should not be like Harry. Okay, you all should be like Henry. Okay, and also the thing. Do you all agree with this? Money is the number one cause of divorce.
Yes.
Oh, why longer? Next time. Experience, is it? Okay, touch wood. Okay. So yes, money is the number one problem. Okay, number one cause of divorce. So Harry, possible or not? Harry, not Henry. Okay, and we talk about domino effect, chain reaction. Anyone know what is this domino effect? Chain reaction? Butterfly effect? Okay, but this is more towards chain reaction. Okay, so look at Harry and his wife. So this is, let's say this is where he is today. So let's say he got two kids, right? So where these two kids learn from? Harry and the wife. Then again, the kid got married. So they learn from who? So this is what we call a domino effect, okay? And this is why you always see in newspaper, in TV, they say the rich gets richer and the poor, poorer. You all say what? Actually, the poor can become rich if only he attend this talk, right? And he listen and he comply, okay? Okay, so what if I tell you that, you know, we can revive all these? We can actually tell Harry that, you know, all these mistakes that he's making. And what if we can really rewind? Can you rewind? Do you all want to rewind back, you know, back to primary school?
Yes.
Why? No homework, no assignment. Okay, so in life, you know, there's no rewind button. So let's see for Harry case. If we teach him, you know, if Harry meets Henry at 3 years old, okay, so he's going to learn all this basic financial knowledge. So, you know, we are going to tell him, you know, it's important, it's crucial to set a budget and follow through, right? And it's important, you know, to live below your means and to know what you want and set your goals, alright? Of course, be debt-free. Anyone wants to be debt-free? For sure, right? Or anyone wants to don't want to be debt free? What is the opposite of debt free? Debt full. Who wants to be debt full? Okay? So yes, be debt free and pay cuts in full. Alright? And then prepare emergency fund, that's for sure, and save for retirement. Easy, right? Finance student, all these things, very, very basic, right? Sounds easy, looks easy, right? But the thing is that knowing is not enough, we must apply. And learning is not enough, we must do. Alright? Okay, again, I want to ask you all. Just now I talked about certificates, the main certificate, that you all say you all didn't practice, right? Okay, what about other things? Okay, for example, okay, what you all learn in your school, in Utah? Utah teach you all those things. Did you all apply?
No.
Some. Okay, why not all?
Hard.
Hard. Or not practical? Okay, I didn't say that. Okay, so yes, for this thing, we must apply and we must do, alright? So, okay, let's start. Now, I want you all to do. Take out your handphone. Everyone got handphone, right? Smartphone, smartphone. Anyone don't have smartphone? If you don't have, then I say, very good, you are very frugal. Okay, so none of you frugal, right? Or using smartphone. Okay, so this is a good app. No worry, I don't earn any commission from this. This is a free app as well. Okay, you go to your Google Play if you are using Android. If you are using Apple, then go to your app stores. Okay, and download this good budget planner. Yeah. Done? No Wi-Fi. No, Utah got Wi-Fi, right? So can access, right?
No connection.
Okay, it's okay. You step down this screen, go back to. Okay? Good budget, G-O-O-D, B-U-D, G-E-T. And then budget planner. Look at the cute envelope icon. Got? Anyone cannot find it? Okay, so let's move on. So after you download and then you start to use, to me this is quite a good app because of, you know, we are all smart people, right? Smart people use smartphone. Anyone use smartphone only for SMS? Or only for WhatsApp? Or only for call? If like that, then please use back Nokia. Okay, so smartphone. So we have to use it smartly. So using your apps, you can actually track your daily expenses, alright? So before that, I want you all to set a budget. So for example, for Harry case, okay? All these envelopes are actually a budget. You know, it's like allocating your salary, where it should go. What's your budget for that particular expenses, alright? So for each of it, for example, eating out, allocate 300. For gas, petrol, 250. Car loan, 530. Rent, 500. Insurance, 500. Car insurance, 100. Okay, so when you have all these, the apps will automatically help you. Like, for example, okay, every time I go out, eat 530. Let's say 10 ringgit, okay, easier. So I just key in. Okay, so each of the expenses, key in. Okay, so for example, here. Okay, then you can ask them to fill for you. Okay, since all of you are still students, so no salary yet. APTVN also consider, right? Not enough, okay. Never mind. Parents allowance? I'm sure your parents give you allowance, right? So you can do budget on that as well, right?
Yes.
Okay, so you can do all this. Fill it in. Okay, done. So you will see a breakdown over here. What I like about this app is that they have this breakdown. For example, if you over budget, overspend, then there's this red indication. Okay? And then of course the pie chart. So you will know that, okay, for now how much I have already spent on which one is the biggest. Alright? Okay, the next one is that we actually have this template. We call it income expenses analysis template. So for those, if you are interested, maybe you can get from Jeff. Jeff, is it okay if I pass you the template if they want to get it from you? Okay. Okay, so this is actually the income expenses analysis template that we use in our financial plan. Okay? Okay, we know that after you keep track everything, is that all? Is just keep track enough? No, right? We have to do some analyze as well. So this is basically how it looks like. It's actually in Excel. So basically you fill up all those income, expenses, and from there it show you the percentage as well. And okay, after that, yes, you have this analysis. So they will calculate for you household, annual household income. Okay, your total household expenses. How much is the percentage? And is that percentage in a healthy level? Alright, so of course we have this benchmark for you to use as well to refer to. Alright, and of course we have this that for you to easy to see. Okay, so money is the seed of money. True? True? Because we use money to make money. True or not? Okay, so we must ensure that we have positive cash flow. Okay, so the next one is that live below your means. Anyone doesn't know what it means by live below your means? Anyone? All understand? Okay, so let's look at some example. Okay, this is what Warren Buffett. Anyone don't know him? Warren Buffett? Should know lah, especially for finance students. So he is the father of investment, father of investing. Okay, so if you buy things that you don't need, soon you will have to sell things that you need. But before? But how many of you practice that? Okay. Okay. What is this? Have you all watched this clip before? This is not a clip, but this is actually a photo showing that a dog. I'm not sure if you go back, you can find from YouTube. You know, the owner trains the dog. You know, they put the dog treats on the nose, and then the dog actually can withstand the temptation. Alright? Have you all seen it? Go back, Google. Okay? Smart people now use Google. Okay? Google. So you just simply type. So in this case, what I'm trying to say is that if dog can withstand the temptation, why can't we? Can you do that? Can you withstand the temptation? Temptation of Starbucks? Temptation of cafe? Temptation of Nike? Okay, students maybe still can. But after you go out to work, with some money, everyone come in, then hard to say. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is that, in our society now, everything is about instant gratification. Have you all heard about this term, instant gratification? Have you all seen those baby, in shopping mall? They cry, they shout, they want the toy, they want. Or you used to be that baby. You used to be that kid, I want now. You tell your mother. Your mother say, cannot, I don't want to buy you this toy. Then you sleep, lie on the floor, turn the one a few rounds. Did you all do that? Okay, so this is, in our society, is a norm now. Everyone looks for instant gratification. But what we are trying to promote is that delay gratification, which means that we should withstand our temptation. Okay? So instead of now, you get something better later. So in the dog case, why do the dog withstand the temptation? Anyone can tell me? Anyone can tell me why the dog withstand the temptation? Why the dog can wait instead of I'm sure the first time the dog doesn't care, right? Anyone got dog here? Dog? So can your dog do that? Cannot, why? Cannot withstand temptation. Right? But why this dog can? Training, yes, training. So why how do we train the dog? How do those people train the dog? Because they give reward, right? He say that, okay, you wait, then I give you two. Correct? So is two more than one? Is that considered breaker? Right? So the dog knows that, okay, I wait, then I got more. So this is what we call as delay gratification. Okay? We wait. We wait for the later on, the bigger, the greater reward. Okay? So again, everything is easier said than done. But is human worse than a dog? Can we train ourselves to withstand temptation? Because no one, there's someone owner train the dog, but nobody train us, right? Anyone train you all? Do you all have any owner? Your girlfriend, maybe? Okay, no one. So everyone is your own owner. So you control yourself, right? So the problem is that, are you disciplined enough to control yourself, right? Okay, so delay gratification. So don't give up what you want most for what you want now. Alright? Did you all know what you want in the first place? Anyone? You know. Still student. Don't need think yet. Okay? But this is very important. You have to know what you want most so that you won't give up on that. Alright? Okay, which is why it comes to the third point. You have to set your goal. You have to know what you want and set your goals. Alright? Did you all want dog treat? Two dog biscuits? No, right? Travel around the world? Yes? Okay? So remember, no Starbucks from now on. You're 5 years later, you want to travel the world. Can do that?
Yes.
Big house? Big car? Anyone want big house, big car? If you want that, then no more Nike. Okay? Wear Bata. You know, Bata is expensive. Wear slipper, no more slipper. Okay? So this is, again, smart people. Okay? So we have to use smart goal. I believe all of you know about this smart goal, right? How to set a smart goal. So I don't have to go through that. But this is basically what I, my licensed financial advisor, do. We do financial plan for our clients. Alright? So financial plan is all about helping our client, you know, wake up call. It's time to wake up, set your goal, and then what's your, you know, current situation, and then how do we help you to get to reach your goal. Alright? Okay, so example, Air Asia. Anyone travel frequently here? Anyone travel frequently here? Or anyone wish to travel? Just now travel around the world, a lot of people, right? Okay, now, okay. So for example, Air Asia. A lot of promotion recently, right? Go where? Korea. Japan. Okay, so this is actually last year one. They just started this flight to Sapporo, Hokkaido. Okay, so for example, in this case, I want to go Sapporo. So I go and find out how much is it. This is my goal lah. Okay, basically this is my goal. So I know that, okay, total flight per person, 2,000, okay? Anyone knows what's famous in Hokkaido? What is this? Lavender. Famous there, right? Or your geography fail one. Don't know what's famous over there. Okay, crab. Like I told you, I love to eat good food. So crab is the thing that I like the most. Alright? What is this? Onsen. Hot spring. Okay? Go Hokkaido, go Japan for sure lah. If you go Japan and you didn't go for this hot spring, then don't tell people you go to Japan. Okay, so just now using the smart. So specific, okay, you want 4 days, 3 nights, Hokkaido trip, measurable, okay, let's say 10,000, luxury trip, okay, you want to stay, you want to go on the onsen, or have to spend, right? Okay, so achievable, so how much you need to save from now? And is it realistic? 5 years later, can I make it? So this one you have to find out, is it realistic? And then time bound, so you have to know where you want to go so that it is time bound, alright? So the most important thing is that when you set all these, then you will have a very, very clear picture, right? You know what you want, so you will sacrifice whatever that you want now and for what you want most later, alright? So these are all the things, all the temptation that I mentioned just now, right? So how do you withstand this temptation? Anyone? How to withstand? Can we simply delete in our mind? Not that easy, right? We are more complicated than computer, right? But what we can do is replace. What is this? Can you all recognize where is this place? Okay. Maybe not. Yes, this is in Japan. Okay, the street in Japan. So you put in all these pictures, alright? All these pictures into your mind to replace. So you can even set it as your wallpaper for your laptop, for your handphone. Alright? But for me, in my case, I put crap. You know, you have to know what you love the most first, right? I want the most is crap. I want to go there and eat crap. So I put crap. Everything also crap. My handphone also crap. Laptop also crap. Okay? So that whenever, okay, maybe I print out one, put in my wallet. So let's say I want to go Starbucks, open up my wallet, crap, oh, cannot. I want Starbucks. Okay? So most importantly, you have to know what you want the most. Okay? So, okay, again, using the apps just now, so you can add in as well. You create another envelope, and then you set as Hokkaido. Then, every month, they will fill it in. Okay? Okay, so whatever the mind can conceive and believe, it can achieve. Heard of this? Can you apply it? Okay? Maybe before that cannot, but now can. After listening to this talk, can. Maybe 1 week after this talk, still can. But please make sure after 1 year, still can. Okay? Okay, so the number 4, 5, 6 actually is quite similar. Whereby you have to set your goal, make your plan, you know, and then get to work, stick to it, and then reach goal. Okay, so be debt-free, pay pass in full, prepare an emergency fund, save for retirement. Okay, so rewind 20 years back. Harry, okay, this time, you know, he already meet Henry. So Henry teach him all, okay? So, or he meet you already, so you all teach him. Okay? You teach him well, right? So this time, Harry, 23, 20 years back, he knows what to expect, right? And he anticipate what is coming. Is that important? So, will there still be Harun? There might be, but you know, you will know that he can pay off all. Credit card, marriage loan, personal loan, housing loan, all he can pay. Okay? Intermediate loan, also can pay. So, what's more important is that Harry prepares for the worst and he hopes for the best. How to hope for the best? Anyone can tell me? You have to make your money work for you, right? Okay, so again, this is something that we do in our financial plan. You know, as a licensed financial advisor, we will do this for our client. So for example, the client, you know, they got, okay, for Harry case, you know, at age what, purchase a car, 45K for 7 years, purchase a house, child education. You know, for this, we will tell Harry, let's say Harry said, I want to buy a 1 million house. And we'll tell him, sorry, Harry, at this point of time, you cannot afford. Okay, so better don't. You go for cheaper one first. So from there, you know, each of these, then we will help him to calculate and project it out. Can he reach? If he cannot reach, what should he do? Okay? And then at the end of the day, we come up with this, what we call it, life fulfillment roadmap. Okay? To fulfill all his goals. Okay? So with the practice of good habits, you know, all the six good habits that I have shared with you all earlier. So it's true that money is not the most important thing in life, but money does affect everything that is important to life. Agreed? Okay, so, okay, tell me, how do you feel now? How do you feel now? Stressful? And then you were angry, you tell me like, wow, money is so stressful, very hard to manage. Is it? Or do you feel relaxed? Not relaxed also, you know that, okay, after come out to work, everything I have to do, budget, every day I have to do budget, I have to keep track budget. Okay, so what we want to do is that, you know, for us, we actually want our clients, you know, we want people around us, we want even for ourselves, all we want is peace of mind, right? We don't want to worry about this, about that. Okay, how many of you are in investment, in any investment? So, still too young. Okay, or any friend jio you for investment? Okay, still too young. Okay, never mind. One day when you go out to work, you will start to have a lot of friends around you. They start to come approach you and ask, I got this compound. You know, you want or not? Opportunity lah, opportunity, investment opportunity. So a lot of people, most of the time, what did you do? What did you all do? So far, have you all come across friends like this? No. Yes, right. So what did you all do? Ignore. I mean, first time, of course, you don't know, so you pick up the call. Second time? Ignore. Then you change the name. Okay? Initially, it's Henry. Then you record, do not pick up. Is it? So that when Henry call again, then you see, okay, do not pick up this one. Possible? But imagine if it's your good friend and you do that, it's not good, right? You will lose a good friend, or maybe it's your relative, or even your family. So what's more important is that don't ignore them. But not to say that you have to go, but at least you know what you want, and you know what to ask, and if the opportunity suits to you, then take it. If not, then just reject. But at least now that you can reject with a good reason. Okay? Because you see, you can show them, this is my plan. If your investment plan doesn't suit to my plan, then I'm sorry. So do you think they will accept your reason? Not really, Very annoying, right? Still call the plan. Okay? But at least now you know what you want. Okay? You won't be affected by others. You won't be influenced by others. Alright? And most importantly, we want you to feel good. Feel good about money. Okay, when you have a peace of mind, you will feel good about money. Life is not just about money, right? There's so many other things. Your time with your family and so on, alright? So tell me, what did you see in this picture? Or which one do you want to be? The top one or the bottom one? Top one. Sure.
Yeah.
So did you do what you need to do to be the top one? Okay? So this is where we say that every one of us, we should be the master of the money. Okay? And make them work harder than you. You work from 8 to 5. I mean, in future, you're still student. You work from 8 to 5. Does your money work from 8 to 5 also? Or your money sleep in your wallet? Or sleep in bank, sleep in the myrotin under your bed. Which one? Okay, so make sure that you are the master of your money. You fully utilize every single cent of your money. Alright? And after all, it's all about making the right choice, the right decision. Correct? Okay, so with that, thank you very much.